Welcome to Azeotropy Academy. This is Deep Datta, and today we'll be talking about a simple trick about the closed loop transfer function. Let's get started. A little bit about me. I'm a BTech final year student at Jadavpur University. I've secured a GATE rank of 150 in chemical engineering in 2020, based at a top pharmaceutical company at the moment. I have 4 months of research experience at IIT Kharagpur, and I have a research paper which is under review. Before going through this lecture, you will need a fundamental understanding of process dynamics and control. At least you should know how a control loop works, okay? So look at this control loop, okay? This is a very standard one that you see in your textbooks. Now, we all know how to find the servo transfer function, that is the Y output by the Y set point, right? Y set point. So we all know how to find this one. We also know how to find Y by D. What is this called? A regulatory transfer function. We know how to find these two. We have standard expressions for these. You will find this in any book on process control. Okay. However, let us say we want to find out C dash by D. Now, this is not the standard one, like C dash by D, right, which is the controller output by the disturbance. So this is the input, this is the output. How do you find this? So here is how you do it, okay? This is what the video is about. You start at your input, at D. You follow this path along the loop, okay? You follow this path. Keep going, cross the controller also, and you end where you want to end, that is C, that is our target, right? That is where you're going to end. So how many blocks have you crossed? We have crossed this one block, another block, another block. So these three blocks have been included in the numerator of this expression. Also, there is a minus sign over here. So where does that come from? See, there's a minus sign here. We are also crossing the minus sign when we are going through this path, right? So this path, we are also crossing this minus sign, right? So the minus sign is also important, and it has to be included. The denominator is generic. It is the same as the servo or the regulatory transfer function. Nothing special about the denominator. So I hope you get the trick. Okay.
So another example where we will just find out, we'll be finding out M by Y set point. Okay. Basically M dash by Y dash set point. So in a similar way, you start at the input and you trace the path till your output point, which is M, which is the final control element output, and the Y set point is over here. Now, the same way you have crossed these two blocks, so you will be including them in the numerator, and the denominator will be as it is. So that's all for now. Like, share, and subscribe. Share these videos to your friends who are preparing for GATE Chemical. Click on the bell icon for notifications. Thank you. I will see you soon.